This is a short talk on the style of brushstroke that I see from Chao Shao-an's work, used primarily in bamboo painting. The essence of spontaneity and the effect of incidental inclusives outside the area of the point of focus, mainly the subject. In the following images that come up there of Chao Shao-an's work showing the style of brushstroke he deployed in his paintings. What I want you to look at is the intersections between one section of bamboo and the next, the pressure and speed of each bamboo stroke, where you can define where that stroke began and ended, and then we're looking at the random chaos of growth that comes off the intersections and that seems to have lodged between the stems of bamboo as incidental inclusives in Chao Shao-an's paintings. And this is what I work very hard on. I see people painting flowers perfectly, exactly as the flower looked. I'd rather use a camera. I look at the bamboo here and it's almost painted as if it's accidental and thrown on the paper. And that style is, in my opinion, just as difficult as making that flower look exactly as it does in real life. This chaos behind the sparrow, we're looking at the bird, its eye, its cheek, and then our eye follows the back of the wing and the tail. The feet don't look like feet. And all the same, there are these peculiar marks in the background where there's a broken brush head scratching out this pattern. In the upper middle, we see a bamboo leaf there. The intersections are incredibly random. Here we see the intersections have been painted with heavy black ink on the wet body of the two sections of bamboo. We see the bleed in the upper middle, and we see the chaos, and try to understand what condition the head of the brush was in, that head, how broken apart were the fibres of that brush head. In Chao Shao-an's work, you look at the birds, you look at their eyes and heads, and whilst your eye is there, you see the bamboo and the rest of the work, like this one, the upper right, you know it's flowers, but you can't actually define what flowers they are, or whether they're just leaves, or some autumn debris which is lodged between the stems of the bamboo. It's a kind of a controlled chaos, but it does have a style. Here the praying mantis has been painted in the same style as the branches, a small snail, and that's a bamboo leaf. It looks like two strokes made that leaf. Again, we're looking at this ordered chaos, but there is a lot of work in it to make it look exactly the way it does, but it doesn't necessarily represent exactly what was in front of him. This chaos is incredible. It really works. It's the power of spontaneous art. It's getting something down that was roughly what I saw, but I want you to know that this is exactly what I saw, and so we see the insect, or the bug, or the bird. Look at the intersection stroke there that joined one section of bamboo to the left section. Look at the graduation. Potentially two strokes made that leaf and this one. And what I'm looking at is that chaos, and I'm looking at the tiny remnants of strokes which are barely visible, as we see here, middle to upper left, that orange stroke, and then something added to it. It was obviously important enough to hold the weight of something else, but it is just debris and chaos which was incidental when he saw the bird. We look at the bird's eye. Everything else flavours the atmosphere of our focus on the bird. The leaves are, they barely look like leaves, but we know they are leaves. And now let's look at how they were made and try and make some the way he made them. Look at the intersection, the black ink bleeding into the red, and then look at the chaos and the mixture of red strokes underneath the black that was added afterwards. The front leg bled into the wet bamboo, Maybe then he went off to paint the intersection and came back to paint the fly, because the rest of the rear legs haven't bled into the wet stroke of the bamboo. So I look at this, I want to know how it came to look like it did. This was painted on top of the brown. Was it windy? Is that what he's saying? Look at the bird's feet. They're hardly bird's feet, but they are, because we're looking at the head and the eye. We look at the flowers. There's a load of chaos lower right. I wouldn't be able to work out what it was. But if we can understand that style of chaos and inclusion, we can create paintings which come close to the way Chao Shao-an saw the world and created that as an incidental something that needed to be there to balance the colour and the shape and the form of the painting. Look at the stroke of the bamboo. Look at the black intersections on the way it's scratched across the paper. It's growth, but you couldn't put your finger on exactly what is branch or leaf or part of the bamboo plant. This is interesting that there's, I don't know what variety of bamboo this would be, but there's the orange growth coming up from the bamboo, and then he's black outlined it, very wet. That's got the body of bamboo, and then another stroke going along the outside in grey. I remember I've enhanced these photographs very contrasty, so that I've brought up as best I can from the book the style of brushstroke that made the painting we see before us. Look at this, and look at this. It's a lot of work, but we've got to understand that that was done in a very quick fashion. And we have to see that even though it's random, even though that it is a chaos of the scrub and the undergrowth that was around, and the way the branches and the bamboo leaves have grown and been battered by the storms, the weather, grown old and shriveled, it's represented by this black stroke. And we have to see, eventually we have to see a continuity of style in the way he represents that chaos. So that's what I've studied. The way the bamboo... Can you see the lazy S in the middle of this painting? There's a lazy S there on the intersection, added afterwards. If we can get the knack of getting that style of chaos into the painting, we could actually find a way of discovering Chao Shao-an's work for ourselves through ourselves, and then we can branch off and expand from that. But I feel that until I have understood the way he created the incidental elements of the birds that he painted, I can't follow in his footsteps and branch out into my own style later. This is my latest painting. This shows bamboo following the laws that I've understood in his work. The intersections, the random black, the representation of growth and branches, and yet there are actually no growth and branches there. The broken brush heads, the broad broken brush head, and the continuation with a finer broken brush head to continue the line and make it look like it was part of the same brush, which I've seen several times in his work, almost like an afterthought later. In this painting, we see the bird and we see the cricket. The stones on the lower right, we don't really see the stones or the moss or the mud or anything. It's we're looking at the cricket and the bird, and this is incidental data, chaos if you like, in the background. Now there's a collection of my paintings where I've put together the lessons I've learnt by using Chao Shao-an as my master by example, by his examples. Anyway, I hope this has perhaps taught newcomers to the field a method of looking at a painting and trying to understand how to see what they're looking at and how to take that and recreate it in a style all their own on another piece of paper. Thank you for watching.